And don't you think that it's strange that I call you by a different name? Whisper to me, oh, never let it snap too far my seconds. Never let it snap too far my seconds. And in time, it's all your fault for the minute. For the minute, it's all your fault for the minute tonight. And you must think that I'm weird.
Howdy, evening, morning, fellow readers. I'm here to do a book review on Parrotfish by Ellen Wittlinger. She is the author of the Prince on a Book Prize, I guess it says on the cover. It says, a compelling and richly detailed story. Okay, this novel's theme is about transgendered people. The main character, Grady, her name is actually Angela Katz McNair. She has never felt like a girl in her own body, and so she decides that she's going to be true to herself and be Grady, a boy. So she shares it with her family, and her family's pretty okay with it and everything like that. She shares it with her friends and everything. Well, she only has one friend named Eve to start with. She finds other friends throughout the novel, which you find out. And I'm going to say, I'm going to give this book 4 stars to start with, because it started off slow, but it was a really good book. The things that that frustrated me a bit, I guess, was I came at this book looking at it to read more about the transgendered side of it, and while this book really did feature that in the beginning, for most of the book it felt just like a normal read to me. There was nothing groundbreaking about it. There was nothing that really hit me about Grady as a transgendered person. For sure, things happened to her, and they were really cruel, and people were cruel, and there were some people who really stood up for her, and there were some references in here that made me laugh and made me really angry, and kind of made me want to do more research about, you know, being transgendered and everything like that. But I didn't really feel like the overall theme of the book was about transgenders and gender disorder, identity disorder. It was, like I said, it was more like a normal YA book. It didn't really go too much into the romance aspect of it. And how she, or how he rather, felt towards people. It did delve into how people felt towards him and other people's reactions. And I thought that was very realistic, because that's what some people are like. And some people really respect and just don't judge people on gender, or don't judge people on sexuality and things like that. But I don't think that they talked about it enough in the novel. I mean, I guess I would like to hear some other people's opinions when they read the book, if they think that I'm on the right note, because I just feel that this book isn't exactly the best book I've ever read. And I think coming at it from someone who is transgender themselves, or you know, trying to find themselves even just as a person, can probably relate to this book and find some solace in it, but I don't think it was really that epic. There were a few scenes in the book that really peeved me off, because Ellen built up to it, and then it was just kind of sizzled. Like, there was one scene in particular, I won't go into too much detail because I don't want to spoil it, but I felt kind of cheated in a way. I think if the author had have actually proceeded with that plan rather than sticking taking another route with it, it would have been really great personal character growth, and it would have been a better conflict, really. It really would have. It would have just compelled me to see how she reacts to that. Fair enough, she reacted. You know, she defended herself. She stood up for herself. But I think it was a little... It was a letdown in a way, because I want to see this character grow. And honestly, she doesn't really grow that much to me. She... I mean, it's the people around her that grow, but they didn't talk much about how it made them feel as well. And I really do admire that she was such a very strong character, and she believed in herself, and she stood up for herself. I think that's a really important thing when you are trying to... You don't have to justify who you are, but when you are... defending yourself and things like that, but I just, it's so hard to describe. Like, it's a really good book, no doubt about it. Like, pick it up for sure. I would like to see some other people's opinions on it for sure. But it just didn't hit the spot. It didn't hit where I wanted it to. It was a good book, but yeah, it's really annoying to try and explain it. You have to pick it up and see what your opinions are about it, which, like I said, definitely. It is thought-provoking for certain. There are just some aspects of it that I just didn't enjoy as much as I thought I would. I love the character of her father. Oh, his father. I keep saying her. His father just reminds me so much of my own father in a lot of ways. And, yeah. And I love Sebastian. He's just so cute. When there is a scene when we meet his mother, and it's just cute. It is hilarious. The one character I really didn't like was Kida, and she is a senior who Grady falls for, and I don't know, her character was just a bitch. Like, not to him, but she was very vague, and she seemed like she was a bitch all the time to everyone except Grady. But even then, she was kind of like vague. I don't know why, but that's just how I felt anyway. A lot of the characters in this book have a good detail to them, but they're not exactly the best characters I've ever read. This is not one of my favorite books, but it is a good read, so pick it up. I'm not so much disappointed with the book as a whole. I'm more so disappointed because I wanted to explore the topic of transgender, gender identity, and I wanted lots more conflicts than this book offered me. Ellen's writing style is actually quite good. It flowed very well, very easy to read. She has a great description. She doesn't ramble on and shit like that, which I like about it. And it's a fairly easy read, though I would have liked to read it a little slower, but I don't know why. I just downed it pretty much. I was addicted to reading it. I read like nearly 200 pages last night, which was insane. So really, really great book for reading. Not intense. If you're looking for an intense book about that sort of subject, I wouldn't pick this up. I would pick it up if you're interested, or if you like LGBT books, anything like that. But if you're looking for something seriously intense, like dark and things like that, I wouldn't call this dark. I would just call it enlightening and provoking and interesting, and a look on transgender. And yeah, so that's Parrotfish. And I don't know whether I'm going to keep this book or not. I probably will, because I want to read it again sometime later on and see if I feel the same way as I did. But, what I loved also about this book, I'm not spoiling it at all, I don't think. Because Grady wants to be a screenwriter, and I thought that was brilliant. It has some, like, screenwriter dialogue, I guess. It's what he thinks. He makes up these dialogue for what people are talking about, what he thinks they're talking about. And it's very funny. It's humorous, and I love that, you know, it's spread out throughout the book. Sometimes it's a bit vague and sometimes it's hilarious. So this book did make me laugh, and I don't know if I've actually I did post-it note some things. So yeah. Anyway, I shall leave it as it is because I got distracted. But yeah, pick it up, read it, and enjoy it. So thank you guys for watching, and this is my review on Parrotfish by Ellen Wittlinger.